Hi, I'm Ting Nguyen with the Science Communication Lab, and I'm excited to talk to scientists who presented with the Share Your Research competition. Today, I'm talking to Isabella. Isabella, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Isabella. I'm a PhD student in the Integrated Program in Neuroscience at McGill University in Montreal, Canada.
And tell me, what research questions are you curious about?
I'm really curious about how you as an individual interact with other individuals, and specifically, what's going on in your brain when that's happening that kind of lets you know who you're talking to.
And what motivated you to get into this particular science field?
So as a kid, I was always really interested in like the animal kingdom and how different animals interact with each other. And especially growing up, like one of the easiest things to look for is, you know, you have a little bird feeder in your yard so you can see all the birds interacting. And you really start to notice after a while that they kind of seem to know who they're interacting with and all sorts of things like that. And that kind of just always fascinated me, just how did they know who they all look identical to me, right? So how were they able to tell? And then as I got older, I got really interested into neuroscience as well, because, you know, all of the behaviors that you do all kind of stem from what's going on in your brain and what's driving your body and all of your behaviors forward. And so the kind of research that I do now is kind of the synthesis of those two interests, where I really get to look at what's going on in the brain when animals are recognizing each other and interacting with each other.
So observation as a like a key thing that fuels your curiosity?
Definitely, definitely. I think so.
As we talked about your research, as you talked about it, you also, one key part is sort of the sound. And have bird sounds and bird calls been influential for you growing up too?
Just going outside and listening to all of them, for sure. I think as I've grown older, I've definitely come to appreciate it more. And especially now that I live in a bigger city where there's not quite as much bird population around, I definitely miss hearing as much bird song as I used to, for sure.
And what's one thing about being a scientist that you wish other people knew?
I really wish people understood more that science is really a process and not just a single hard truth. I think especially in the way that science sometimes gets reported and sometimes gets communicated, there's this impression that it's like you do all this research and you find this immutable truth about the world and that's never going to change, when really science is such a process of building upon what other people have discovered and building upon knowledge that we already know to discover new things. And I think understanding that this is something mutable that can change is really important.
And in working in science, you know, you're talking about some of the discoveries and curiosities that people make. If you were to talk to a young person who's interested in going into science, what are some of the great things about doing research and what are some of the most challenging things?
I'll start with the most challenging things first. I think it takes a lot of hard work and it takes a lot of persistence, and you do kind of have to be prepared to just commit to doing a lot of work before you see a lot of the payoff. But I think the great part about that is once you have committed, you're not alone, first off. Like, you have, you know, a whole lab working with you. Like, it's such a collaborative process, and getting to interact with so many other people from so many walks of life is really a rewarding experience. And when you do end up, when you've done all the work and you do end up with this like new thing in your hand, and you're the first person to see this new data and how it all comes together, that's just a really incredible feeling.
What is one of your first science memories?
One of my first science memories is probably, I guess I have kind of twofold story for this. One is more naturalistic. So I remember being, I think I must have been like 8 or 9 or something, and I'd seen some robins building a nest in a tree, and then we had a big storm, and the next day, obviously, the nest was on the ground and it was kind of like broken up. So I spent the whole rest of the day like digging out mud, putting it back together, and then I set it all nicely into a little bush. And I tried to dig up worms and put them in the nest for the robins to come back. And I just spent hours like just looking through the tree leaves to see if they were coming back or not. And obviously they weren't going to, but that was really fun for me. Additionally, also my grandmother used to work in, she used to teach biochemistry. And so when she was taking care of me, she would take me to sit in her lab and she would set me up in the back of her lab with a Bunsen burner and just little jars of like flammable chemicals. And I would just sit there for hours with a little stick, dipping them into the chemicals and putting them over the fire and seeing what colors they went. And I figured out the whole firework color scheme and it was really fun.
Actually, my one last question. What do you love about the brain?
How complex it is. I think it's like the basic workings of it are so simple that we've known about them for a really long time. Like, you know, action potentials and the neurons fire and the electricity is what carries information. And yet we're still discovering all of these new like nuances to that. And then not only on the cellular level, but when you zoom out and focus on the circuit level or even on the brain level, you get all sorts of emergent properties and the complex ways that it all interacts with itself. Like, I just think it's fascinating to be able to think about untangling even just a small part of that.
It's been such a pleasure to talk to you. And I hope you at home will check out Isabella's research talk and how she untangles the neural underpinnings of individual recognition in the brain. Thank you so much, Isabella.
Thank you.